This week on What's New in the EU.
Hello. Thank you.
Hey, welcome to What's New in EDU. I'm Tony Jackson, a fourth grade teacher from Hackensack, New Jersey, and I'm here at BET, a place where their mission is to bring together people, ideas, practices, and technologies so that educators like me can learn about new updates and features. So you are in good hands, my friends. Today we have big news to drop on the topic of creativity. Let's go take a look at what Karen from the Hacking STEM team has in store over there.
Hey, thanks, Tony. It's Karen from the Education Workshop, and I'm here with my colleague, Kaylee Daniel, a math teacher from Renton, Washington. And we are here to celebrate the new lesson plan from Hacking STEM, which is a math lesson that looks at topography and how engineers can think about building transportation systems of the future. So Kaylee, tell us a little bit about the lesson plan.
Yeah. Okay, so with the students, you start with Pythagorean theorem and proving that a squared plus b squared truly does equal c squared no matter which way you put it in. And no matter what your leg lengths are, that's still consistently true regardless of proportion. And then we use that information and that knowledge with the students to be able to calculate the estimated road distance of each of these segments knowing the leg lengths on the map. So we do half of them with Pythagorean theorem and half of them with the distance formula, knowing that they are interrelated. Then we will build these tools either with Lego
or here in cardboard, and these tools actually connect into Excel, correct?
Yes. So this is an Excel workbook, and it's an Excel interface that shows both angle measurement using this tool, or this tool, which is a glorified protractor, or distance using this wheel or that wheel, depending on which one you're using. We're going to use this wheel for this particular demonstration. So having already measured AB and having that show up in my Excel workbook, I'm now going to measure BC. Now, with any kind of measurement, you have to tell it when to start. So I'm going to tell it to start. And then I will roll all the way to the other part of the line segment. And then I will click Save. And because it is live data, then it will pop up with a line segment that is BC and is representative of this line segment BC on my map.
So what's really interesting about this lesson plan that we've done with LEGO Education is being able to move from the 2D world and paper world into a digital world, and now students can export that route into 3D paint. And that 3D environment, they're allowed to actually add topographical elements like animals and trees and other kinds of vegetation and be able to work with their island in 3D and see their path actually represented there. The other thing is we really like to hack here at Hacking STEM, and we've been thinking about how to take that and move it now into an augmented reality, something that 3D paint does. So my colleague Dave here can show you that we have a prototype of that same route being projected over a Lego island. Now, all these lesson plans are free, and they're written by teachers for teachers.
I hear that there's new curriculum also coming up from the Minecraft education team. Neil, take it away.
Thanks, Tony. Speaking of new curriculum, the Minecraft education team has an awesome announcement here at BET. Students and teachers in over 100 countries are already teaching and learning with the game, and today we're happy to announce the chemistry update coming to schools around the world in February 2018. Let's take a look and see how it works. We have here a few new tools as part of the chemistry update for Minecraft Education Edition. The element constructor allows students to take protons, electrons, and neutrons and control those either with typing or sliders and create elements. We have over 100 and hundreds of isotopes available in the game as well. For example, I'll just create one simple like hydrogen. Moving along to the second tool, the compound creator allows me to take those elements, for example, 2 carbon, 3 hydrogen, 1 sodium, and 2 oxygen, and spit out sodium acetate, which I'm gonna need to create some pretty useful stuff in game. So let's slide over here to this third tool. The lab table allows me to combine the items I just built. And again, teachers love this because it forces students to create all the way from elements all the way to the items. And the only way to get these items is for students to actually engage with the science. By hitting combine on the lab table, it's going to spit out this item for me, which is called an ice bomb. I'm going to hop over here to this water, equip the ice bomb, and I can start taking all of this water and turn it straight into ice. not only do we have all of these new tools available in-game, we also published 10 lessons in partnership with chemistry educators, as well as this chemistry world you see in front of me, and a full-fledged teacher's guide for educators to use around the world. The chemistry update will come to Minecraft Education Edition in just a few short weeks. We're so excited to see the fun and creative ways that students and teachers experience science. Back to you, Tony.
Love it. Fun and creativity are two very important educational tools. So promoting creative self-expression with students in fun and exciting forms is a surefire way to empower through tech. Now stick with me. We have so much more that we'll be covering all week. Make sure to tune in live on Facebook at 4 p.m. London time every day.